Have you always wanted to learn to play tennis, but you've been unsure where to start? Do you love watching that piano or sitting down with the dominated coach and hope to be just like them? Playing tennis can help you build speed, power, and fitness. It's also a great way to spend time with your family or your friends. Learn the play under the coach, the scoring system, and broader playing techniques. You need to become a tennis pro. Find an opponent you can, the basics you need an opponent to practice tennis with. Ask anyone you see playing at your local court if they be interested in helping you learn. If not, try asking friends or family or even searching online for the local tennis associations. You can practice basic serving techniques in any closed open space, but it's best to spend as much time as possible on actual court. You learn the layout of the court faster and minimize the risk of breaking anything with your racket or the ball. Buy tennis supplies. You don't need to buy professional tennis supplies right away, but every beginner will need to have a few things to get started. Some junior tennis clubs provide basic supplies for their members, but if that isn't the case, you need to go shopping. You need a racket with this case for a beginner. All you need to do is check to make sure your hands fit comfortably around the handle. But if also shouldn't feel like it's too heavy to move, the racket shouldn't feel like it's too heavy to move. But it also should feel like it weighs nothing. There are also men's and women's rackets, but you should try all the time fit over genders in most cases. By at least 3 tennis balls, they get lost very easily. Buy tennis clothes before you buy tennis clothes. Ask your gym or club if they have any clothing requirement. If not, any clothes, comfortable athletic clothes will be fine. Stricter clothes may require you to buy tennis shoes, tennis shoes and shorts, and tennis skirts for women. However, this is not always the case. Tennis shoes are the best to play tennis in, but if you don't have them, any pair of sneakers will do. Find an opponent. Once you learn the basics, you need an opponent to practice tennis with. Ask anyone you see playing at your local court if they be interested in helping you learn. If not, try asking friends or family or even searching online for a local tennis associations. Learn about the possible court, figuring out the different areas of the tennis court. It's the first step in learning how to play. Different possible courts are better for different kinds of play. So spend some time walking around the court before starting to practice. Tennis courts are divided into by a net. One side is your and the other reach your opponent. You can touch the net or hit the ball into it in game. The parallel line furthest from the net is the baseline. You stand here to make the first serve. The small line in the middle of the baseline is the central mat. You stand to the left, the right of this mat to serve. There's a thinner line between the baseline and the net. This is the service line. You and your serve center the area between the net and the service line. The service area is divided into vertical halves, perpendicular to the net. The servers into left and right sections. The two lines on this side of the court, perpendicular to the net. This divide the servers. There's the inner, the two lines. The two lines on this side. The two lines on this side of the court, perpendicular to the net mark, the boundary of the court. The inner line is for the singles game. And the outer reach for doubles. Learn the basics of tennis scoring. One player serves the proper game from the time the ball is served. One point is available to either player. The game ancestor has the basic of tennis scoring. One player serves the proper game from the Thunderbolt Lister. One point is available to either player. The game ancestor has go for points with her. The learn the basic of tennis scoring. One player serves the proper game from the Thunderbolt Lister. One point is available to either player. The game ends. Zapter has the point is the one that goes out the bounds or you hit the net or is missed by a player. The game ends. Zapter one player has scored 4 points with a margin of at least 2 points over the loser. If both players, for example, a scorer for the 2 miss, that the game is over. But the score for the 3 miss, that the game must continue. Tennis game begin with 0 points on this side. In tennis, a score of 0 is called up. Score your call at the beginning of 5 points for the score of 1. The announcer or server will call list 15. For the score of 2, the call list 30. For the score of 3, the call list 40. For the score of 4 or a winning score, the college game. It's the point is the one to the player who doesn't let the ball hit the net bounce twice or go out the bounce. It's the rejection gains the point, breaking the serve occurs when the player who didn't serve wins the game. Play all do rất the game in set, tennis is played in set. Dù đồng just play one game. And then go home. Set consists of at least 6 games. The set doesn't then lead to one player win 6 games. Then has the margin of to win over their opponent. For example, a scorer for the 2 min. Play all do rất the game in set, tennis is played in set. Dù đồng just play one game and then go home. Set consists of at least 6 games. The set doesn't then lead to one player win 6 games. Then has the margin of to win over their opponent. For example, if one player has won 6 games, then the other has won 5. They'll have to keep playing until the winner has 2 more wins than the loser. If above ticking tennis matches usually consist the 3 or 5 sets. Practice hitting the ball with your racket before you start serving or playing. Just use to your racket than ball. Practice tossing the ball in the air and hitting it until you can hit the ball hard a few times in a row. Don't worry too much about accuracy right now. Just get a feel for your racket and a feel for the ball. Just get the feel for the racket and the ball. The feel for the ball. Learn how to do a forehand stroke. The forehand stroke is played by holding the racket out. Then your dominant hand, like your second hand with the then pivot so that you wipe the racket behind you and hit the ball landward and deep upward. This stroke is best for softer. Higher serve. Try a backhand stroke. The backhand is one of the easiest strokes to master. Rip the racket with both hands. Then hold it down to the side. It should look similar to baseball and bat back. When the ball approaches, hit it hard at the slide. Double angle. This stroke hits the ball hard and this is a red way. To be sure that your ball will get danger the server separate. When you on serving, there's also a one-handed backhand stroke. You use the dominant hand only. But everything else stays the same. This one is a little tougher to manage. Learn how to do a volley. Volleying is the way to return a low serve. There are two kinds of volleys. Forehand and backhand. In the forehand volley, you hold the racket in your dominant hand. and hold it down with your arm with standing until the head of the racket is roughly parallel to your head. When you on the backhand volley is performed similarly, except the back of your hand faces the net, the motion in the backhand volley is similar to elbowing someone out of the way while crouching. People going to choose your server in tennis, one person starts the first serve of the game. Most players choose by flipping a coin, and in most cases, the person who doesn't search gets to choose which side of the court to play on. The server keeps serving until the game ends. For the next game, the other player will serve. Position yourself in a baseline corner. The game starts with both players on the baseline. The server chooses the corner of the baseline to serve from, and the other player position themselves on the opposite back corner. So if you serve from the right corner of your side of the court, your opponent will stand in the far left corner from your point of view. You should be standing facing the opposite corner. Keep 1 foot slightly above the baseline and the about baseline, about 45 centimeters, 18 in away inside the court. Hold your racket out there, reason the required way to hold the racket as long as you keep your hand. As long as your hand is around the handle, grip the racket firmly in your dominant hand. And hold it down with your arm extended until the head of the racket is roughly parallel to your head. There's also a one-handed backhand, so you use your dominant hand only, but everything else stays. There is also a one-handed backhand, so you use your dominant hand only. But everything else stays the same. This will need to cover to back place. Throw the ball into the air with your opposite hand if you're serving. Toss the tennis ball into the air with your racket. It's okay to toss the ball around a few times without using your racket. Or to bounce it on the court before beginning the official serve. Get used to the ball and how it handles before you serve. If you want to do a practice toss, don't hit it with your racket this time than your fault. We could give your opponent the points. If you're on serving continue holding your racket and waiting. Serve the ball to the server set rear when the ball approaches. Hit it hard that the slide double dangle is just hit the ball hard and it's a good way to be sure that your ball will get danger the server separate. When the ball approaches, hit it hard that the slide, if the ball hits the net on the way to the other side of the court, it's called the lead and you can do the serve over again. If the ball stays on the side of the court, goes out the bounce, or you miss the server, that you get the it's a fault. You can get one to over for the fourth, but if you fourth charging one serve, the point is awarded to your opponent, and the game moves on to the next point. Run to the opposite back corner and hit the ball back. Immediately after you hit the side, run to the opposite side of your baseline. Hit the ball firmly with the face of your racket, pointed slightly upward. It takes some practice to learn how to return the server successfully. So don't worry if you do badly the first few times. Continue until the point this one, the point this only awarded when the ball falls out of play. So keep playing until one of you wins the point. Points can last anywhere from a few seconds to several minutes. But at the beginning, the point will probably be awarded quickly when the point this awarded. You call the score and serve again until the game missed one. And then again, until the set this one. Hit an overhead return, and overhead return is a shot where the other player blocks the ball up high over your head. And you aim to slam it down on his side. So it's nearly impossible to return. Waiting until you serve with a very high ball to try this one. is one work corner normal sir. Tôi cho rắc kẹp bác bởi hai do hết sự is greater do bác và được bỏ lít do màu to bởi do hết snap bị đau đỡ rắc kẹp over the net just that you would do with the sir em chưa đi up the side được bước phòng cho hậu nền. You can also do an overhead sir by performing the same actions while serving. Put toss spin on your stroke. Adding toss spin on your stroke can help the ball bounce higher and move faster. Don't hit the ball head down to the center of your racket like you usually would. Use your racket to hit the side of the ball. Immediately after you hit the side of the ball, move the racket upward, then strike the top of the ball. This makes the ball spinning an upward rocket instead of moving in a straight path. Just slice the ball. Slicing the ball allows you to change the direction of the ball and just slow it down enough to make it lose enough momentum so that this toss from the opponent scores before they have a chance to get to it. Just slice the ball, hit it from underneath first, then immediately bring the racket forward to the opponent's side. This will slow the ball down as it approaches, making the opponent more likely to miss. Learn to play on different surfaces. There are several different kinds of surfaces. You can play tennis on and each can affect your playing speed and abilities. Learning to master tennis on multiple surfaces can help you improve your game significantly. Hard surfaces like Castford and Acrylic are more common in North America. They tend to be good for beginners because the surfaces allow for more bounces. But they can be hot on players' choice. Clay surfaces are most common in Europe and Latin America, and they tend to make the game play slower, the ball loss of bounces. Higher standard clay court, grass court are the kind used at Wimbledon grass court games, tend to be very fast hit the ball bounces less than the player. It's far more advanced than the doubles. It's more likely to miss the serve. Fix your opponent's strategy as you get better at tennis. You learn how to study and use their strategy and references against them. This is the skill that takes a lot of time to develop, so don't worry if you do badly the first few times. Fix your opponent's strategy as you get better at tennis. You learn how to study and use their strategy. Then references again them. This is the skill that takes a lot of time to develop. So don't worry if you can do it right away. Many players, especially beginners, are most comfortable with one specific stroke. If you notice that your opponent likes to strike the ball high with her forehand motion, you can learn to show them low balls that require a backhand motion. Many players either love a hit blink close to the net. Figure out how your opponent feels about playing near the net if they spend most of their time on the baseline. Set the ball close to the net to force them up there. Study your opponents. Get to know your opponents. So every player has their serving style. If you always serve the ball in the same height, the ball in the same direction at the same height, make sure you're standing there to return the serve. Study the opponent. Mental stress scatter upset opponent. It's a vulnerable opponent. If they are reacting angrily, missing easy shot, or don't seem to be paying attention to the game, that in your win by serving a variety of shots to confuse them. Learn to play double tennis. Double tennis has to play on this side instead of one using the way the coach mentioned. But the rest of the scoring and rules remain the same. The big challenge for double tennis beginners is to learn how to interact with a teammate as got the tennis link fast to teach you the best strategies for double tennis. There is also one
There's also a variety called Canadian doubles, in which one team has two players and the other only one is usually played in situation where the single player is far more advanced than the doubles. Hold your racket out there, present the required way to hold the racket as long as you keep your hand on hand. As long as your hand disrupts around the handle, grip the racket firmly in your dominant hand. With the back of your hand facing the baseline, hit the ball. As long as you keep your hand on hand. Hold your racket out there, present the required way to hold the racket as long as your hand disrupts around the handle. Grip the racket firmly in your dominant hand and hold it down with your arm extended without the hands. Let the racket is roughly parallel to your hand when you are serving. You can hold the racket. When you are serving, you can hold the racket with both hands. Usually, the dominant hand will grip the top of the handle with the other hand. That the border, but there's no required position. As long as you keep your hand on hand on the handle only. Be patient with yourself as you learn the sport. People spend a lifetime perfecting theirs and strategies. Just continue improving your game over time. Hire a personal coach, trainer who will work with your skill set and help you to develop your shots. Measure your standing. Measure your opponent knows that the beginner will even agree to the best game standards temporarily to help you to develop your serving and hitting techniques where you feel confident in your basic skills technically and your basic tennis skills. When you feel confident in your basic skills technically in your community, you meet people who love the sport as much as you do, and you see how you stack up against the competitions. Jason. Jason, playing sneakers, the cast ballet blast heels or flip flops are not suitable for playing tennis. Playing sneakers, the cast ballet blast heels or flip flops are not suitable for playing tennis. Once you perfected your basic tennis tools, you can learn to block hidden overhead and hit broadly. If your elbow forearm already so after playing tennis, put an eye patch on the sore spot to ease the pain. Avoid playing for the day also to give the tendons time to recover.